ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. If the dream of reason produces monsters, the theater dispels them with its magic. Now be afraid before the conjurer who conquered the creatures of the night. With his genius and his heart, give a big round of applause for the mighty toy maker. The famous and beloved toy maker, we will learn, has a sad fate over his head. For in spite of his goodness, a path of tragedy and death he will tread. Day and night in his workshop he labors. He hammers, he sweats, and he fasts. With every blow he strikes, sighs fly from his soul to the figures he carves. Famous and beloved toy maker, day and night in his workshop. Splendid choice! His fame spreads in whispers across the land far and wide, until his name is known and respected by every man and child. One fateful day, a nobleman knocks at his workshop door. He's jolted from his work with a start. The promises and smiles from Walter Bernhardt conceal a dark, hideous heart. Fateful day, a nobleman knocks at his workshop door. Excellent decision. Walter offers a roof, friendship, protection, The Bernhardt's castle will be a dazzling mansion for the old toy maker and work of his craft. Curse on you, Walter Bernhardt, for deceiving such a good soul. May you be damned to spend all eternity in hell's darkest hole. Walter offers a roof in the Bernhardt's castle. Very astute. Our hero works away happily in the castle of his dreams. But soon we will see his perfidious master's purpose is not what it seems. Oh my God! This is no castle, but a prison! Poor toymaker, now you understand how
house is your perdition.
Hide yourselves, boys and girls. Walter Bernhardt is preparing an invocation here. Terrible creature of hell is about to appear. Extraordinary!
Oh no! The demon is conjured the charm! Take cover now, if you're pleased to be alive.
Oh no! The toymaker's talent now comes to his perfidious benefactor's end. Far behind him now are the toys and the theatre he had made. Oh, if only to undo this vile spell there were some chance, and so release the good toymaker from the grip of his vile trance. The toymaker's talent, toys and the theatre. But the toymaker's good heart shines through, you can tell. And a little love is all it takes to destroy the terrible spell. Now you must think fast, toymaker. The situation is dire. Walter Bernhardt is returning. I don't know how you can escape from this now. Oh, what a terrible and fortunate idea, boys and girls. Come on, little one. Hold on to that heart so pure and true. In a distant and hopeful future, you may return it to the one who gave it to you. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the heart of a man whose goodness went deep. Listen now and decide if you will wake from this long.
You see, I suppose my memory will return in time.
Your memories are of no interest to me, Toymaker. I'm looking for the Mirror of Fate.
The Mirror of Fate? If I'm not mistaken, the mirror was broken many years ago. Yes, now I remember. It was when the Lord of Darkness was defeated by his own son. The castle came down, and the mirror broke. I vaguely recollect seeing it amongst the ruins. Wait! I found a friend and I kept it. Now I remember. What's happening?
Let's see how well you play your deck. Come on!
Oh, my. What happened? What was I saying?
You were about to give me a fragment of the Mirror of Fate.
Ah, yes. Here it is. Oh, yes, good, good. You know, it's all starting to come back to me. I know who you are. Oh, my.
Goodbye, old man. Guard your heart well.
But he brought me another piece.
There are still some missing pieces.
There is one other piece, and I know who has it. But he isn't here in the castle.
Where is he, Sam?
Close your eyes. Just for a moment.
Very well.
I'm pleased to see you again. What happened to you after you destroyed the Acolyte? I lost all trace of you. Where have you been?
Attending to my own affair.
Ah, I see. But of course you have been away such a long time.
Everything appears to be in order, sir.
The other acolytes will know one of them is dead by now.
Indeed. But they don't know who was responsible. I'm sure word will reach them soon. I have little doubt that they will discover who it was before too long. I am afraid that they already suspect you have come out of hiding, my friend. Even as we speak, a powerful presence searches for you in your little hideout in the church.
Who?
An envoy of the Acolytes, I believe, though I cannot be certain.
I'll go and see for myself. Whoever it is may lead us to them.
Accompany him.
No. I don't need a dog.